हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू द कोर्स ऑन इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन। दिस इज़ द नाइन्थ वीडियो लेक्चर। इन द लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर आई हैव डिस्कस विथ यू अबाउट लैमिनेशन। इन दिस वीडियो लेट अस सी अबाउट कोर स्ट्रैगरिंग एंड इट्स कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस इफ नॉट प्रॉपरली कोर स्ट्रैग। यू नो कोर स्ट्रैगरिंग मीन्स प्रोसेस ऑफ बंचिंग ऑल लैमिनेशन। सपोज वाइल bunching all lamination, some air gap is present between lamination, what it will result? Let us see one by one. The first disadvantage is that if air gap is introduced between lamination, reluctance will increase, which cause increase in magnetizing current. So air gap increases, reluctance increases, for same five I mu increases and power factor decreases. So if air gap present between lamination, it will reduce the power factor. So I have explained this with an graph here. Let us see, this is wrong, you forgot this. See, take example one, when there is no air gap between lamination. This is an example two, whereas air gap is present between lamination. This is the value of I mu and this is the value of I z. This is the value of I naught. I naught is under root of I mu square plus I w square. Now take a second case where air gap present, so that I mu increases because reluctance increases to maintain same flux. I mu increases, now I naught increases. So by if air gap is introduced, I naught increases. This is the first observation. Let us see the second observation. The second observation is that this is I1. Sorry friends, this is phi 1. The angle between V and I naught is phi 1. See the angle between V and I naught, phi 2. This is phi 2. This is phi 1, whereas if you see clearly, phi 1 is less than phi 2. So cos phi 1 is greater than cos phi 2. So if air gap increases, I have shown you I mu increases, I mu increases, I naught increases, power factor decreases. So it's very important that during core staggering, no air gap must be left inside. And one more point for you, the no load current of transformer is 2 to 6% of full load, whereas in case of induction machine it is 30 to 40% because of air gap. This is the reason why in all rotating machine, whether it is a DC machine or AC machine, we are not using CRGO steel. We are settling for silicon steel, because if you use CRGO steel also, we cannot going to reduce air gap. So I mu value still required very high whether you use CRGO or silicon steel, whereas cost of CRGO is very high and we must need to import it because that technology is not available in India. Hope you have understand the concept related to air gap, what is the disadvantage and various machine. Let us see, since the topic air gap has come, let me discuss about the slots, open type slots, closed type slots and semi-closed slots and their magnetizing current and air gap. Since this is not required in transformer, I will give a just brief discussion, but when I deal with you induction machine, I am going to teach this in depth. Okay friends, let us see how this air gap values will be there in three slots. See, when you take open type slots, the leakage value of flux is very less because it's surrounded with air gap. The flux try to close its path in low reluctance path, so that instead of closing its path with air, it's go with core material, so that The leakage flux XL is very less in case of open slot winding, and XL is very large in case of closed type of winding. This point is very important and must be dealt very elaborately in induction machine or synchronous machine. For time being, just take as example. Now see, I mu in open is very slot, because I told you air gap is large, so that reluctance increases, I mu increases. I mu required in closed type winding is very less, and so if I mu increases, power factor decreases, power factor of open is very poor. Now where we are going to use these kind of slots? In induction machine, we are going to use a semi-open slot in induction machine. In DC machine, we are going to use open type slots. Where we use closed type slots, friends? In small rated machine. Now you may ask, why these applications vary? Because in DC machine, you might have read the concept about reactance voltage. When commutation is going on and the current in coil changing from minus I mu plus I mu to minus I mu, the reactance of coil which undergoing commutation, that is which is short circuited, offer its reactance which oppose the change in current. So a delay commutation is observed. To reduce the delay commutation, we need to reduce the inductance, and XL value decreases with open type slots. So we use open type slots in case of DC machine. Whereas if you take a closed machine, closed type machine, closed type of slots, this since we are using in small rated machine, the rotor of machine is very small, so that it will pick its rated value speed very fast. For if during starting current is very large also, since it going to come its rated speed very fastly, starting current flow for very less time. And whereas open, I have told you, closed type of winding has XL very large, because it is slots is surrounded by core, so that instead of passing the flux from stator to rotor, it's going leakage flux going to close its parts with stator, in stator only, because it surrounded by iron parts. So XL increases in case of closer type of slots, so that I value decreases automatically. So by closer slots, leakage flux is more, I naught means starting current will decreases. Furthermore, the rotor will come to its rated speed very fastly in case of small rotated machine due to less inertia. So for small rated machine, we are going to use closed type slots. In DC machine, we are using open slot to reduce reactance voltage. And in case of induction machine, we are using semi-closed slot. The reason I will discuss in induction machine topic clearly. Since the topic of reluctance and I naught value came, I discuss as an extra point here. Let me ask you one question, friends. This question was asked in one of the interview to my friends. They have given the graph. They have told you this is the value of I, V, this is the value of I, the power factor is cos phi. Now they have given a second graph, voltage is sinusoidal, current is a square waveform. Now what is the value of power factor? Now you told, if you have read power electronics, you might easily answer this question. I have added this question just for curiosity, whether you have read power electronics or not. As I have told you, I have started Electrical Master YouTube channel. If you haven't subscribed there, go and subscribe there. And whichever subject you want, comment in the comment box. I will start in next course. And let's move ahead, friends. Since this value, this parameter, you will not understand now. I have just added here. If you know already, have a look on it. But if you want me to explain, wait for the course when I am going to start induction machine. I am going to discuss all this point clearly. But if you have read, once have a look so that it will clear the points. So move ahead, friends. Now see the first consequences we have seen, that is have poor power factor. Let us see the second consequences called magnetostriction phenomena. This question was asked in ISO interview. What is magnetostriction effect and tell me the disadvantage of it. I am going to ask you one question. Now please try to answer this question. Now just try to answer in the comment box. If you get wrong, I will answer it in next interview. What is stroboscopic effect in tube light? Just answer it in comment box. Let's move ahead. See, due to magnetostriction effect, transformer will make noise. Not only transformer, the choke in tube light also make the noise. Because, see, sinusoidal curve will have positive value for half cycle and negative value in another half cycle. During this positive cycle, the length of core material going to increase slightly. Change, and whereas the length in negative half cycle going to contract. This expansion and contraction in core material will result in hissing noise, that is called magnetostriction effect. This effect increases more when there is an air gap present between this lamination. See, the change in dimension is 10 power minus 8 centimeter only. How? Only 10 to the power of minus 8 centimeter. So it cannot be viewed with naked eyes, but this phenomena can be understood by observing hissing noise, because this noise which is made is around 100 Hz, because during first cycle it going to magnetize, during second time it is going to demagnetize. For one complete cycle, one magnetizing and one demagnetizing is occur. So the output frequency of noise is twice the input frequency, so that noise is heard around 100 Hz. If input frequency is 60 Hz, noise will be 120 Hz, and you know 100 Hz will fall in the audible frequency range, so that we are going to hear this noise when we near to a transformer. Whereas 10 to the power of minus 8 centimeter change cannot be viewed with naked eyes. We are not going to see this changes. One more point, let me ask you a question. Since audible range is 20 Hz to 20 kHz. Just for curiosity, I have added an extra point. If you want, you can see here. If you use RC phase shift oscillator or Wien bridge oscillator in analog electronics, they are going to be in this range. Which of the following oscillator comes in audible range? The answer is RC phase shift oscillator and Wien bridge oscillator. The oscillator which comes in radio frequency range is Hartley-Kolbrecht oscillator. Now you might I am asking a question. If you know, try to answer in the comment box for this also. Since we have an RC phase shift oscillator, why we need to go for Wien bridge oscillator? Means what are the disadvantages of RC phase shift oscillator and Wien bridge oscillator? Tell me friends in the comment box. If possible, if you don't know, I am going to reply in next video lecture. Let's move ahead, friends. So hope you have understand why it came 2 into supply frequency. The third point you must note here is that noise level also depend upon flux density in core, because If you see the flux density in distribution transformer is less than flux required in power transformer. So if you see here, power transformer make more noise than distribution transformer, because in distribution transformer flux density is less. Why less? I am going to discuss in future, but the point is that iron losses in distribution transformer taking constantly, whereas copper loss take only when load present. Whereas iron losses taking 24 hours to reduce the iron losses, you know, hysteresis losses depend upon P power X and eddy current loss depend upon B square. So to reduce these losses, we need to reduce B max value so that a distribution transformer has less value of flux density compared to power transformer. So we are going to use less value of flux density in case of distribution transformer. Hope you have understand this. So finally, noise level can be reduced by using proper staggering and by reduce Bmax. Hope you have understand this. Since I am reading so many textbook and so many notes, it take me lot of efforts to make these notes in a simple manner. I have using so much points and combining with so many subjects, different points. It took me lot of effort to make this video. If you like this video lecture, please hit a like button. So final conclusion is like this. Now move ahead. What is the shape of core material? This is an important point. See, we are not using a square waveform of core we are using a cruciform of core. The reason why is I have not drawn properly, but if you see this d2 value in square type and d1 value in cruciform, d1 is less than d2, means if you use cruciform, diameter of circumference reduces. Less dia means less insulating material, less number of length per ton. This is the main advantage. Actually, the main point behind using a cruci point is third point. Length per ton is length less, so that amount of copper material required is less. If so much option is given and we have to choose only one option, option for third, and size will reduce. D1 is less than D2, so that size will reduce, cost, weight, everything reduce, utilization factor will increase. So we are going to use a cruciform of core instead of square form. Now move ahead. Let's, since we have discussed much about core material, and let us see the type of core also in brief. In future classes, I am going to discuss more about this when we are dealing with topic on placement of windings in core. In that, I am going to elaborate each and every thing points in elaborate manner. For time being, just accept it. See, this is a core type transformer, this is a shell type transformer. In core type transformer, core is surrounded by winding. That means this is a core and winding surrounds the core. Whereas in shell type transformer, this is a shell type transformer, winding is surrounded by this core. Core is there outside, winding is inside. Whereas if you see, leakage flux is more in case of core type transformer, because primary and secondary are in at a large distance. So to reduce this leakage flux, we are going to use interleave type of winding. I am going to discuss this when we are placing the copper windings on core of transformer. For time being, just accept it that leakage flux is more in core type transformer and less in shell type transformer, because shell type transformer remaining is iron part, so that leakage flux try to close the part from iron rather than in air. Now move ahead. See, it is a series magnetic circuit. Yes, you can observe from it. It is a parallel magnetic circuit. Both limbs have same cross sectional area because winding is placed on both limbs. Whereas here, winding is placed only in middle limbs. Outer limbs is empty. So it has only half cross sectional area. Copper requirement is more in case of core type transformer because see, this is core. Listen carefully, friends. This is core. We keep an insulating material here, then we keep LV winding. I will going to discuss why LV is near to the core in future classes, just accept it. This is again an insulation. Since this is an insulation, this is LV, this is an insulation, this is HV. So copper requirement is more, but the insulation is required only to between core and LV and core and HV, whereas copper requirement is more. Once again, see here, you have kept an insulation here and kept a LV winding, then again insulation, then again HV winding. So tons per length in HV winding is more. You kept an insulation, then wound wire on it, again insulation, then wound HV. So the length per ton of HV is more than LV, so copper requirement is more, whereas insulation we require only of two types. So if insulation requirement is less, so that we can use it for high voltage requirement. Now see, insulation level is directly proportional to voltage. If voltage rating of transformer increases, we have to increase it to insulation level. Since insulation required in core type transformer is less, we can use for high rating machine. Whereas copper requirement is more, if we are going to use more copper, I square losses increases. So this core type winding is used for low current and high voltage. Low current and high voltage, whereas shell type transformer, I am going to discuss with you, it is a sandwich type winding. You know, no sandwich in your home? See, strictly speaking, in shell type transformer, we keep LV, then insulation, then HV, then insulation, then LV. Means we add sandwich type of winding. In between HV, there is LV. In between LV, there is a HV. We, on top of the winding, all this LV by 2 windings we are keeping to make a symmetrical network, so that axial forces is balanced, which I am going to discuss in future classes. So stay tuned here. So the insulation is required more because LV, then insulation HV, then again insulation LV, then again insulation HV. So insulation requirement going to increase in case of shell type transformer. So shell type transformer is used for low voltage rating, because if you use for high voltage rating, insulation must be increased. Already since insulation required more, you cannot use for high voltage. So shell type transformer used for low voltage and high current. Why high current? See here again, listen carefully. This is a shell type transformer. This is LV, insulation, then again HV, LV, HV. Length per ton of LV and HV are same. Whereas in core transformer, you are putting LV near to the core, then on putting an insulation, then you are putting an HV. So that length per ton of HV is more in case of core type transformer, which is not true in case of shell type transformer. So copper requirement is less, so we are using for high current rating and low voltage. Shell type is used for high current and low voltage. Hope you have understand this clearly. In future classes, I am going to discuss more when I am going to discuss with placement of winding, which will be the next video lecture. This is 9th video lecture. In 10th video lecture, I am going to show you elaborately. Let's see a question here. See, for a given cross sectional area of transformer core, stepped core are used for. This was asked in engineering service interview, engineering service prelims question. See this, they have given four options. First, to reduce core loss. Actually, strictly speaking, yes, it is true. because the diameter of cruciform less than diameter of square, so that material requirement is less. You take hysteresis losses. Hysteresis losses is proportional to b power x, f and v, volume of the core. If you use the cruciform, diameter reduces, volume reduces, hysteresis loss reduces. Yes, it is true. But eddy current losses does not depend. Eddy current losses does not reduces. So, first option is a little bit true. Second, to provide more mechanical strength to the core. Third point is to reduce conductor material. Yes, cruciform reduce conductor material because diameter is less. You require less conductor material, which reduce I square R loss. Yes, it is true. To reduce magnetizing current, it is not necessarily that much true. So, if answer is like 1 and 3 correct, you have to choose 1 and 3. But if you have to choose only one option, third one is more appropriate than engineering service. See, in engineering service, there are few questions which are controversial, in which more than one answer can be true. But you have to select which is the best one. And this was asked in engineering service exam. So, option third is correct one. Hope you have understand this clearly. If you have any doubt, please comment in the comment box. You are not commenting. I am please like and comment so that I know I can understand what you want actually from me, and which subject, which topic you want from me. So please comment in the comment box, and few question which I have asked you, please try to answer in comment box. Thank you, friends.